Please join me in singing our gathering song, "Come, Now is the Time to Worship."
Welcome to our liturgy for the 32nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. This second Sunday of November, we remember all of our deceased loved ones who have passed away this year. We say a special hello to our students and faculty who join us for this liturgy. Our usual custom here at Ave Maria Parish is to read the names of all of our recently deceased, and we will be doing that right after the homily. Thank you for joining with us today in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, thinking about the past week, we call to mind our sins. And for the times we have failed to love and failed to forgive, we now ask the Lord for his pardon and his peace. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep us from all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her, and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care, because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
First letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish one said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's Gospel is about being ready. Ready for when the Lord comes. Throughout this month of November, we remember all those who were ready for the Lord, ready to go home. This month of November, we pray and remember our loved ones who were marked with the sign of faith. All during this month, the church places the Easter candle at a prominent place. It is a symbol of the resurrected Christ. During today's Mass, we will be reading the names of loved ones who died this past year. Some of illness, some of old age, and some from COVID-19. Each one was loved by a family. Each one had a story. I would like to share with you today one story from a priest who lived with us for a short time, Father Jerry Petringa. He lost his dad during the spring. It was only recently that he sent us this letter, and I share it with you. When my dad died on April 19th of COVID-19, we were in the beginning of a pandemic. A state of emergency was declared on March 10th. My dad turned 100 on March 14th. The birthday celebration that we had planned for him was canceled. And during that time, he contracted COVID-19. For more than 4 weeks, we were not allowed to visit him. He never really understood FaceTime. So on Easter Sunday, I put a ladder up to his window so he could see me in person. On the Monday after Easter, he started to suffer from the symptoms of COVID-19. By that evening, he was in a morphine-induced coma. On Tuesday, we were allowed to sit with him. We stayed with him until he died on Saturday, April 18, shortly after noon. Due to the shutdown, we were unable to have a wake or a proper funeral. It was just a simple burial with military honors. Only 10 of us were allowed to be present. My dad, like all the others who died during this time, deserved better. Saying goodbye to Dad has seemed unfinished and incomplete business. Hence the delay in acknowledging to your kind expression of condolence. The delay in no way diminishes its sincerity. It's just that I had been hoping for the opportunity for more closure before responding to you. In a few minutes, we will be reading the names of our loved ones who have died, each one with a family, each one with a story. I invite you to remember any loved one who has gone home to the Lord. May they all rest in peace, and may the perpetual light shine upon them forever. We remember Carrie Adams, Emery J. Arsenault, Angela Barletta, Michaela Barone, Shara Belgiorno, Lou Bertolami, Christine Bolognese, Mary Bruno, Matilda Bonapai, Florence Capozzi, Angelina Catoni, Gabriella Centeno, Angie Chase Isager, Mary Ann Kalar, Phyllis Del Greco, Edward Delisle, Susan D. Downey, Peter Andrew Elliott,
Bill Faria, Francis Federico, William R. Ferrara, Gertrude M. Ferrara, Cassie Ferenzi, Father Arthur Flynn, Jim Frontero, John Gallagher, Tommy Garvey, Pamela Gioso, John Gioso Sr., Ernest Les Goodwin, Ralph Grande, Ettore Guardia, Rosemarie Guerrero, Nicholas Guerrero, Rick Jarvis, Orfelina Juhas,
Alice Kirby, Paul Kirby, Dr. Vincente Legman, Elizabeth Landrigan,
Enrico S. Pomerino. Dominic Petrino. Richard E. Polito. Geraldine Sassa. John James Shalou. Priscilla Sheehan. Joseph Sheehan. Irene Sheehan. Teresa Shimkowski. Teresa Simpson. Kevin Smith. Francine Spada. Joan Stack. Adrian Stella.
Robert Strauss. Rafaela Suchko. James Tomagini. Jack Tortorici. Mary Trabucco. Ida Varga. Robert von Wittenberg.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace.
Together we now profess our faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate with the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in the Lord to hear our prayers, we bring to mind our needs and the needs of the world.
That all who minister in the church be leaders who serve and servants who lead. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our country continue to honor all who have given the ultimate sacrifice in the quest for freedom, and that the veterans who give service to our country receive the honor and appreciation they are due. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who dedicate their lives to the welfare of others, including all medical personnel, for our first responders, for priests who have answered the call to serve those afflicted with the virus, and for family members who serve as caregivers, that they persevere in spite of discouragement or weariness as they continue to care for our neighbors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing and recovery of all those suffering from COVID-19, and for all who are homebound or suffering from chronic illness, for those impaired by addiction, and for all those who cannot join us at this time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that especially during this month of November, we may remember those who have gone before us and find comfort in our generous and merciful God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for those for whom we promise to pray, for those who have no one to pray for them by name, and for the intentions of those remembered in our parish bulletin, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Adrian and Paul Stella, William B. Kalman, and Norman and Maria Glenn, for whom this Mass is offered, for a special intention for the peace and strength of all educators, and for all our beloved dead, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gathering up all of our petitions and the souls of our loved ones, we place them in the hands of Our Lady as we pray together.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
And so, in the company of angels and saints,
We now sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith.
Christ, our Savior, taught us.
Our Father, who
us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have some announcements for you. Please continue to register for Mass each week by Thursday, 12 noon. Everyone must wear a mask or face covering in church for the foreseeable future and observe social distancing directions. While Linfield continues to be listed in the higher risk zone for COVID-19, we will take everyone's temperature as you enter the church until further notice. Cardinal Schron continues to lift the Sunday Mass obligation only for those who are ill or those who are having underlying health conditions that make them vulnerable to disease. If you are not feeling well or in frail health, we encourage you to remain at home and to watch Mass on our website. Otherwise, we invite you to join us for one of our in-person Masses. Our churches are safe, and we practice all the recommended guidelines to protect everyone in attendance. And finally, thank you so much for your continued financial support through your offertory contributions to Ave Maria Parish. You can make a donation as you leave the church today, or sign up for our online giving, or mail your contribution to our parish office on Grove Street. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God now bless you and your families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go now in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in our sending forth song, Shout to the Lord.